Alrighty, time to do another little M12 draft here. And what do we got? We got Gideon's Avenger, which is pretty sweet. Stinger Fling Spider, which is also pretty sweet. A Fire Slinger, an Assault Griff, and a Dusk Hunter Bat. I think of all these, I think Gideon's Avenger is probably the pick. Stinger Fling's probably the best card in the pack, but yeah, I like white a lot more than I like green. And Gideon's Avenger is very good. I mean, when you have it in play, your opponent's generally not going to be able to attack you very effectively. And white has all sorts of things that can make them, get into awkward spots, like a tapper or an Alluring Siren, that sort of thing. So yeah, we'll just go ahead and take the Avenger. And what to follow it up with? I mean, obviously the best card in the pack is Chandra's Outrage. The question is whether I want to directly move into red right after taking a white card. And, I don't really think I do. I mean, especially a double red card. So I might actually just take Assault Griffin here and try to remain open. That seems fine. I like mono white anyway. And sometimes you can't play mono white because the packs don't have any white cards in them. I'm not quite deranged enough to just take Divine Favor here, which means I gotta pick another color. Well, there's a bunch of mediocre cards in every color. I mean, Chasm Drake, Child of Night, Basilisk, Bonebreaker Giant. Basically, there's every other color has a, random expensive guy, except for Child of Night, which I guess is not too expensive. But Black White's not the best. Blue White's a little better than Black White. I mean, and Chasm Drake's fine. It's good with Gideon's Avenger, I suppose. Sure, we'll take that. All right, that's a pretty easy pick. Banalish Veteran's pretty good, and again, we know we're gonna play it, so we'll take that one. I see. I mean, the best card in the pack is the Fire Slinger, and then there's also what, like a Scepter, a Lurking Croc, Peregrine Griffin, Fleetwing. I think it's gonna be the Griffin though. It's again, I think one of the better cards in the pack, and it's white. So the aggressive white decks I like tend to have almost all white cards. Now the best card in the pack is Sorin's Thirst. Got past a couple of Child of Nights, which means that black's reasonably open, so I could definitely take Sorin's Thirst. Cancel's not a card I'm going to take here. I could take Mighty Leap to go with the other guys I have here, which is not the worst. I mean, the aggressive white decks would do like Mighty Leap, but it might be better just to take Sorin's Thirst. I mean, the mana is going to get kind of awkward, but you could still run something like 10 plains, 7 swamps, and cast it reliably, or somewhat reliably. Yeah, I'm just going to take that. I think it's enough better than Mighty Leap that it's worth the risk, even if I might not play it. Now I've got a choice between Oromancer, which has, as of yet, no targets, or Bloodseeker, which is a very good aggressive card. Black-white beatdown. That might be the call here. Yeah. Seeking Blood. Alright, and then Guardian's Pledge is fine. I mean, I still could be almost mono white even if I'm taking a couple black cards here. It's that or Dark Favor, which I don't like quite as well. Dark Favor does get in there on like Assault Griffin, for example. I'll take the Pledge. Ooh, Armored Warhorse Wheeling. Alright, we're ditching everything else then. Reassembling Skeleton's cute and all, but at this point, I think the white cards have it. All right, hide those. It's the only playable left. Yeah, just take that. And I guess that's a. I mean, it's playable. So, all right. So black seems to be open, but don't really have a huge incentive to take it yet. Hide the Chasm Drake, since yeah, that's not gonna happen. Could very easily just be mono white here, though. I would not mind splashing a Doomblade or whatever. So, I guess we'll see what comes up. All right, speaking of Doomblade, now here's the choice between the Doomblade or the Stormfront Pegasus. Hide the Devouring Storm, since I really hope that's not going to make it. I think it's better just to take Doomblade here. I mean, I like removal, and as good as Stormfront Pegasus is, I'd rather have a white deck with a couple Doomblades than a mono-white deck with a couple Stormfronts, I think. All right, who knows, maybe that pick will get me into trouble. All right, well, crap and a stave off, so I guess I'll take the stave off. I mean, Thran Golem is fine, but not a card I look to pick up, especially not second. Jeez, all right, here is a pack. So now I've got to decide if Honor the Pure is something I'm interested in, which it probably is, but Elite Vanguard's pretty close. I mean, the thing is, Guardian's Pledge does a good approximation of Honor the Pure, whereas, having a, I'd rather have like an elite Vanguard and two Guardians pledges than like an Honor of the Pure and two Guardians pledges. But Honor of the Pure is a pretty powerful card. Might be good just to take that and slam all the white creatures I see. Yeah, I want to get a good sense for how good this is anyway. All right, Benalish Veteran. Man, late Stinger Fling. I'm going to have trouble beating the spiders that are going every which direction, but, you know, I will take my white creature and be happy. Same with here. I think I'm just taking Oromancer. I can maybe pick up Divine Favors later, but for now I'd rather have the Oromancer. All right. How does this make sense? How does our fifth pick overrun just sitting there? And nothing else I'm going to play. All right, I guess I'll just take the overrun. I mean, I'm not splashing Warstorm Surge, so whatever. All right. Second Oromancer, which right now they just look like Grey Ogres to me, or a Rock Egg. I think I'll take the Rock Egg. It might not be the most aggressive card, but if you have a Rock Egg, they are not attacking you on the ground. Ooh, Arbalest Elite. I will go ahead and snap that up. All right. So I have a pretty good start. This overrun is complicating things. I'm not going to play the overrun, but there's nothing in that pack, so Mize. Probably not going to play Bloodseeker either, but I could see playing Doomblade Storm's Thirst in an otherwise white deck. Go to cost sort. I could use some more creatures, though. Let's hope to pick some more up here. So I could take Siege Mastodon or Crumbling Colossus here, and despite the fact that I have Honor of the Pure, this might be better. No, I think Honor of the Pure and Guardian's Pledge combined to make Siege Mastodon a little more attractive. All right, Hideous Visage is cute and all, but I'd rather just play this card, so I'm gonna take Plummet, which is quite a danger to me. Mind Rot's a reasonable sideboard card. I guess I'll take Manalith, even though just look at all these green cards here. I don't care if anyone plays any of those cards against me. And all right, so basically all I want out of this pack is white creatures. So maybe that Doomblade over a Pegasus pick did not work out so well. I don't know. I mean, we'll see, I suppose. Oh my, what an exciting first pick. A Peregrine Griffin. I mean, it's gonna be that or Tormented Soul. Or I could take a Sunpetal Grove and try to splash Overrun, which doesn't seem all that good either. So, yeah, I think the Griffin is it. I mean, Tormented Soul is the kind of card I would like, but I don't have any creature enchantments to put in it, and I don't want to play enough swamps to reliably play it turn one, so. Well, all right. Yeah, this is pretty miserable. Not a single good white or black card. I mean, I guess I could take a Warpath Ghoul. I really don't want to, though. I don't really want another 5-drop either. Certainly don't want a second Manalith. I mean, I could take Guardian's Pledge and just hope to pick up enough white creatures. All of these are very not appealing. I'm just going to take Warpath Ghoul. I think that's the safest pick here. And then, of course, Elite Vanguard and Doomblade show up. I'm still just going to take the Doomblade, though. I mean, you can't go wrong with having too many Doomblades. All right, this is a little more like it. Now we take Stormfront, passing green cards everywhere, and a Sorin's Thirst, but I need the Stormfront a lot more here. I'm probably not. This is not a Diabolic Tutor deck, that's for sure. So it's like Crown of Empires or Stonehorn Dignitary. I think I'd slightly rather have the Crown. It's pretty close, actually. I mean, Stonehorn Dignitary is just like a terrible guy, but with a Honor of the Pure, it's a 2/5. That's not the worst. Nah, Crown is still gonna be a little better, I think. All right, no enchantments, so this is horrible, and this is horrible, but I guess this is slightly less horrible. Yeah, things aren't getting better. This draft is not going well. Oh, I guess I'll take a Disentomb, though I do not intend to play it. All right, probably playing that Bloodseeker too, now that I think about it. Not playing Devouring Swarm though. And don't really want to play Swiftfoot Boots, but I guess I might. It's also a decent sideboard card against a really removal heavy deck. Alright, I guess I'll take the Guardian's Pledge though. Yeah, not going to be playing it. Alright. Not playing three, and Land of Realms is a pretty nice one. Seems like someone should have been green this pack, or this draft. Possibly me. Possibly going to play against the green player and just die now. All right, well, there's a Divine Favor. I mean, I'm going to play it. It goes well with my Oromancers. All right, so we're going to play the Bloodseeker. Got to cut something for that. Maybe cut one of these stupid Guardian's Pledges. I don't know. Find out in a second. Ta-da! We've got, I think, a decent deck. Basically, if these two black creatures and, like, this Divine Favor were just three more white creatures, this deck would be pretty sweet. As is, it's kind of borderline. I mean, it's got a couple removal spells, and, Sorcerer's Curse goes there, and, you know, a couple good creatures, but it's also got, you know, some Oromancers and a Rock Egg and a Guardian's Pledge, so a little awkward. Let's go piles by color. I think I'm going to play 10-7 here. No, I'm not playing 13-4. 10-7 seems fine. I want black reasonably early, and I have a double black spell, and my white's not that color intensive. I mean, Guardian's Pledge I don't need till later, so yeah, this should do it.